in the Bible.
People come up to me all the time and say, you should be a model, or you look just like a model, or maybe you should try to be a man who models.
Essentially, transgender ideology holds that people can be born into the wrong body. It's simply not true. Human sexuality is binary. Okay, we know this because in nature, reproduction is the rule. And human beings, we engage in sexual reproduction. You need a man and a woman to do that. Women are XX. Those are the sex chromosomes. Women have two XXs. Men have an X and a Y. Those are genetic markers. They're genetic markers for female and male, respectively. Okay, binary. That's the rule, and it's self-evident. Transgender, someone who identifies as transgender, however, that's not a problem in their body. Gender identity, all identities, they're in our thoughts. Thoughts and feelings, those are not hardwired, they develop. And they may be factually wrong or factually correct. The definition of a delusion is a fixed false belief. So if I persistently, consistently insist that I am Margaret Thatcher, or persistently, consistently insist that I am a cat, or I'm an amputee trapped in a normal body, I am delusional. And in fact, there are people who believe they are amputees trapped in a normal body. They are appropriately diagnosed as having body identity integrity disorder. If you want to cut off an arm or a leg, you're mentally ill. But if you want to cut off healthy breasts and genitals, oh, then you're transgender and you don't have a mental illness. Individuals with disorders of sex development are being used as pawns in the fight for basically a civil right to a mental illness. There's no such thing as a civil right to a mental illness, but that is in fact what we are dealing with the transgender rights movement.
I'm too sexy for my love, too sexy for my love, love's going to leave me.
Cat. I'm too sexy for
My love, love's going to leave me.